Hello, good morning, good afternoon, good evening. This is Amos Tarfa. Just want to share in this series, The Diary of a Young Person Pursuing Excellence, episode 5. Let's go ahead and take a step and look at three young men from Israel back in the day, or three young men who were friends with Daniel from the book of Daniel. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego are the names that they were given. You might be familiar with them. And I just bring this up because we live in a day and time where you will be questioned for basically, why do you believe what you believe, and what will you stand firm even in the face of adversity if you believe that what you believe is true? Now, what is interesting is that the group mentality, group think, and group mentality thinking that is becoming so prevalent in our culture, we need to be very careful with how we approach that. When you hear a certain stance or a certain belief system, you need to make sure you ask yourself, what is the basis of this belief system, and does it stand on truth? And so I look at the culture and I see how easy it is for people who stand for what they believe to be ridiculed and sometimes to be insulted. And so I look at these young men, three of them, and they were living in Babylon because they were taken as captives from their homeland. They were taken as captives. And the reason they were, by the way, going into captivity, let's talk about that for a second. The reason why the young men went into captivity was actually because of the idolatry of the people that they were, of their people. They had sinned against God, and that led to trouble. And part of that trouble was them being led to Babylon. Again, you can go back and read in world history and see what happened. This is around 600 BC when this happened. So these men were taken to Babylon. Babylon was a huge empire back then in terms of its influence. And these young men were told, right, they came to Babylon, but they still held on to their faith in God, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. They held firmly to their belief. If you haven't read the book of Daniel before, I really want to encourage you to look at the book of Daniel. You will learn about some of the most exceptional people of integrity ever to walk the earth in the book of Daniel, including Daniel and then his friends, these three friends. And so these men were told that there's a statue that has been built, and when you hear certain sounds from certain instruments, you're supposed to bow down and worship this statue, right? This might ring a bell today, but we'll come back to that later. There's so many times in our culture where we're told we have to bow to this or bow to that. But these young men said they were not going to bow to anyone other than God. And so these men, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, were told, you're going to hear these sounds and you have to bow down and worship the statue of the king. And they said they were not going to do it. Well, finally, the king called them in and he said to them, guys, when you hear the sound, you need to bow down and worship. And the response that these young men gave is one that blows my mind. Okay, so today again, our focus is Daniel and his friends. The response that these young men gave to the king, mind blowing. Here's what they said. They said, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego answered and said to the king, O Nebuchadnezzar, we have no need to answer you on this matter. In a sense, he told them, go think about it, go prepare. When you hear it, make sure. Because he had asked them, is it true, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, that you do not serve my gods or worship the gold image which I have set up? Now, if you are ready at the time you hear the sound of the horn, the flute, the harp, the lyre, and the psaltery in symphony with all kinds of music, and you fall down and worship the image which I have made, good. But if you do not worship, you shall be cast immediately into the midst of a burning fiery furnace. And who is the God who will deliver you from my hands? That's what the king told them. If you hear the sound, you can do what I have told you to do, which will be good, or you will be thrown into the fiery furnace. And the young man said, we have no need to answer you in this matter. If that is the case, our God whom we serve is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace. This is the part that is just mind-blowing. They said, and he will deliver us from your hand, O king. But if not, let it be known. That is, if not, if God allows them to get burned up in this fiery furnace. They said, but let it be known, O king, that we will not serve your gods, even if God does not deliver us from this fiery furnace, nor will we worship the gold image which you have set up. These men said, we will do what we believe and we know is right, even if it costs us our lives. We will stand for truth. My friends, when we look back upon history, when we look at World War II, we hear about people like Corrie ten Boom. We hear about people like Gladys Allworth. we hear about, and then we even go back now to, if we take a step back to the 1800s, to other times in history, people who stood for truth, even though it could cost them their lives. You think of people like Harriet Tubman, which I have a video I'm going to make on her story. But when you look at these people and how they stood for truth in the face of adversity, my friends, this should remind you that you should not compromise when you are being forced to believe in something that you know is not right. Stand for truth. Stand for your convictions on the matter. And this matter at hand is serving God with all our hearts, as it tells us to do. So young people, please let us stand for the truth of God's word. It doesn't mean that we'll be popular at the moment. However, because God is love and his word is truth, we will be doing that which is right, and ultimately we will actually be helping more people. Even if society doesn't see that at the moment, ultimately we're doing what's right. Because Corrie ten Boom and the work she did in saving the Jews back in World War II, some people might have viewed that and not have been happy with her. We know some of the soldiers, for example, in the army would definitely not have been happy with the work she was doing. But she did what was right. For the most part, those who end up doing right are those in the minority. Sometimes the people in the minority do that which is right, but they might be ridiculed at the moment. But many years later, you look back and you say, wow, that person stood for what was right. Young people, I hope that we'll stand for what's right. I hope that we will be like Daniel's friends. There's so much more we can learn from the book of Daniel, so I want to encourage you to read it. Tell me what you think, and then we can talk more about lessons from Daniel. I pray that you will continue to pursue excellence in all that you do so that you help others along the way, even as you flourish. Take care and have a blessed weekend.